Hi guys! So I'm new to this group and I'm excited. So I want to talk about how flipping important Sundays are in our house. I know that for some of the people that came with me, Sundays is absolutely the most productive and get done day. So let me explain. Besides, so I'm Kara and I love Blaine, and me and Blaine want to spend the next 30 days together with you guys in helping you reach your goals. So one of those things about reaching your goals is having it in your face. And I was always like, whatever, I'll remember. I never remember. I'm a mom. I have a mom. I have one of those too. I am a mom. And it's so important for me to write things down, like physically write them down. I feel like there's a strong connection when it comes to pencil or pen and paper and not just putting reminders on here. I try to take away and unplug from here and be some mirror on auto, put this on autopilot as much as possible so I can be one-to-one with my kids. So my kids are the ones that are home. I have five technically. So the ones that are in the house are 4 and 3, and our 4-year-old has autism. So with that being said, there's a lot of therapies and there's a lot of doctor's appointments and there's a lot of behavior plans that I tend to forget, so I have to keep them in place. So writing it down, just making a like having a planner. I didn't start this way. I started with like a Dollar Tree planner and worked my way up to like the big, scary, bulky ones. But breaking down my goals for the week are important and putting my priorities, which means date night with my husband and sex with my husband, which means all the people I have to call. Like I have it for Monday and Tuesday, dentist, call the eye doctor. But I only put three major things down. Okay, so on Sunday, I generally write down a giant bucket. I write down everything that comes to mind that I want to do. Wow, that's weird. Write down everything that's worse. I want to do for the week. I get it all out of my head to take that overwhelm away from me, and then I write it down on paper. And then I take those that giant list I just like blurted out on a paper, and I take it and I spread three things out throughout the 7 days. So that way I'm not overwhelmed by just seeing that list and trying to wake up and be like, oh, I'm gonna pick that one and do that one today. No, I have it scheduled out throughout the week, so it's not overwhelming. It's not complicated. I made time for it. I scheduled it up. And one of the big things also, besides planning the week, is scheduling my workout in. I work out 4 or 5 days a week, depending on what program and the intensity and not wanting to overkill my knee. But I just schedule those in. And also on Sunday, we meal prep. Amanda's in this group and she's absolutely amazing with meal prep. So she'll be talking about that a little bit. But Sunday, like today, David and I are currently vegetarian, so we're making veggie lasagna and fruit cups and snack cups for the entire week. And also, for example, Amanda has two kids, and she preps even their clothes for the week. Her kids are 5 and 2, and she preps all their clothes. So whatever you have to do to take the stress off of you for the next 7 days is important. Don't try to change all your routines all at once because that will overwhelm you as well. But as you gradually learn how to plan and schedule your week, and as you gradually learn how to meal prep for the week, some people do it in like 3-day increments. So they meal prep on Sunday and then they'll do it on like Wednesday and Thursday again for the last 3 days, depending on what they cook and how long and like shelf life, what is it, life? Shelf, what? How long it lasts in the fridge. So whatever works for you, it's just very important to understand that if you wing it, those are the nights when you wing it that you'll end up at McDonald's, or you'll end up eating a whole box of cereal or ice cream, or just being like, ah, F it, we're just gonna do this. So please take the time today and for the next 4 Sundays to understand the importance of meal prep and understand the importance of planning your week and understanding the importance of putting your priorities, your kids, your husband, yourself, your food, your whatever that like brings you alive. Like I like crafts, I really enjoy craft. So I plan that like twice or three times a week. So whatever you can do, please try to find time today it's a meal prep, it's a plan your week to just get it all done, so then you're not winging it all week. All right, you guys are awesome. I'm so excited to be here. Tomorrow I'll be posting a list of awesome audios you can listen to first thing in the morning, so you don't wake up and decide to let life run you. All right, you guys are awesome. I'll talk to you later. Bye.